To analyze this line, we need to know where it hits the y-axis and at what angle. This angle is generally referred to as the slope, which is essentially the amount that y changes when x changes by 1 unit. In other words, when x moves 1 unit from here to here, y changes from here to here. Note that this is a positive relationship, and we want to find what's the change in y when x increases by 1 unit. That's the slope. But remember, in the case of regression, this line represents how much y is expected to change when x changes by 1 unit. Therefore, when we write the equation for this line, we denote it by y hat. There are many ways to symbolize the y-intercept and slope. You may have learned the generic y equals mx plus b, which at least in the United States is usually how it's taught. That's where m represents slope and b represents the y-intercept. But really, we can symbolize them any way we want. The important thing is that once we decide on how to denote them, you have to remember that and continue to use that later. We can also write it like this, because addition can go in any direction. 2 plus 3 is the same as 3 plus 2. The slope times x plus the y-intercept is the same as the y-intercept plus the slope times x. Sometimes one of these, the slope or the y-intercept, might be negative, so it's just important to keep that in mind. As long as we keep those negatives and positive signs correct, the order doesn't matter. The slope and y-intercept are called regression coefficients, and sometimes when we use software to calculate the regression line, they'll present it in this first way. For this lesson, we're going to use b to symbolize the slope and a to symbolize the y-intercept. Given this, what will be our generic equation for the regression line? Select all that apply.